happiness director or a happiness manager or a happiness executive. So job title has evolved into being deemed or called a happiness expert. And it's not HR. And it's a very, very unique role. And it's really looking at, I suppose, it piggybacks on employee wellness, but it's really looking at the well-being of people in the organizations to manage retention. So it's important to be aware of that. So part of the program is to really look at helping you navigate through this transition and where next. I spoke briefly about starting a business. I know with ValueEd, and it's not to go into a lot of details there, but I think Vic, you know, you can talk about that as well a little bit later. But you know, there are tools available to help you. So we can start to, part of the program would look and help you and identify that and give you some direction in terms of where you can actually go further to get the assistance that you possibly need, if that's the path you're taking. I think with COVID, particularly globally, has created a lot of entrepreneurs, interesting enough. A lot of people have gone, well, actually, I can't find a job, or I'm applying for positions and I'm being rejected and I'm not being successful. I need to start making money. I can't be doing this. It's not an end. There has to be an end to my job search. And so we've got to start getting creative and started looking at ways. You know, the job uncertainty, I encounter a lot of conversations where a lot of people are just looking permanent. I'm just looking for a permanent job. That's permanent is secure. And I've said to so many people, right, the job that you're in at the moment, is it permanent? And they say to me, yes. And I said, are you facing retrenchment at the moment? And they say, yes. I say, guys, permanent is not necessarily always secure, but you've got to just be open. So the whole idea with the program and with coaching and the methodology that we want to instill here is really getting you to think differently. And it might mean that your job that you need to be looking for right now might be actually freelance. It might be contract. So if you're going into the market and it's just about permanent, you might be getting zero results. And that's because you're doing this, which I understand, but sometimes we need to take the blinkers off. And that's the idea that we want to work with you on from that perspective. So it's about job searching within the organization, job searching possibly outside of the organization. Where does that job exist? And those are some of the elements that we will look at. So let's look at it. I talk about getting you to design a proactive job campaign plan. And that's important because you've got to have a proactive strategy. You can't just simply be applying for a position and then expecting a result. What if you don't get a response? So what happens if you're applying for jobs and you're absolutely getting zero feedback? We talk about that being ghosting. I'm seeing that a lot on the social media platforms. I'm seeing a lot of complaints from job seekers at any level, by the way. It's graduate level right through to executive level across all areas, all industries. And they're applying for positions and applying and getting absolutely zero feedback. So we need to empower you with the tools. We need to empower you with the techniques about how do you change that? What do you need to be doing differently? So if you are doing something and it's not working, sometimes you've got to take a step back. And then in order to move forward. So, you know, what does that proactive plan look like? How do we get you and how do we help you design a proactive plan? What is your brand? Sure, you know, your brand position at the moment is so important at any level, you know, whether you're looking to transition within your current organization, whether you're looking to transition without, you are up against competition. And, you know, before COVID, there were a lot of job seekers applying for the same job. And with COVID, and if you've been impacted by retrenchment and you are in the market looking for a job, you're amazing skill. You've got phenomenal skill. You've got experience. It doesn't necessarily mean that you are not at the top of your game, but it also doesn't mean that you're you're not the strongest. You've got competition, and how do you differentiate yourself from that? So that is about your branding. LinkedIn is a phenomenal tool in order to help you brand your brand. Your CV, what does that CV look like? You know, are you putting your best foot forward in terms of your CV? And we start to look and share some advice and guidance in terms of what that CV should look like. In the CV and in the job application process now, you've also got to consider artificial intelligence. You've got to consider that AI is being utilized to screen a CV. Now, that is not a bad thing, because if I'm a human being and I'm getting 400 job applications, which, by the way, is quite common, I physically, as an individual, I'm not going to go through 400 applications. So you've got to be aware of what is actually happening in the market and how do you make sure that you are effectively positioning yourself. So just look at these statistics around LinkedIn. I mean, you know, it is a key source of talent. It's not just only about advertising. It from recruiters and employers, it's not just about them advertising the job. They are also using it to identify talent. So you might be searching for a job today and you're getting zero results. But as an employer in a company, they actually might be using LinkedIn to find you as talent and earmark you as talent and future talent. And so LinkedIn is not only about just looking for a job today, it's about making sure that you are managing your professional brand to take your career forward. So there's a number of different elements that we can look at, and I'll jump onto a couple of screens in a moment now and just take you through that. And then also we look at networking and the power of networking. How do you network to put your brand in front of your future employer? And then obviously part of one of the modules that we look at is also interview preparation. But right at the end, I'll just take you through the different elements of the program that we wish to cover with you over the program. All right. So let's just look at the CV. Today's session is not unpack and to go into a lot of detail around the CV. A CV session is a session on its own. But just to give you an indication, these are the common issues why CVs are rejected and why CVs are not even opened. You know, people are not customizing their CV. They're not demonstrating their value proposition. They're not demonstrating why you're the best person for that particular job. You know, all the customization is happening in your cover letter and not in your CV, but the CV is the document that I click on to determine whether you are effective. The AI is also screening the CV, not necessarily the cover letter or the motivational letter. You got to look for differentiation. If you are applying for a position, you're not the only one applying. So if you've got strong competition, what are you putting forward that's going to differentiate you? Very, very important. You need to be able to get that through, and we need to be able to show you what is important so that you can position yourself effectively. Formatting. Gosh, guys, spelling mistakes, formatting, errors. Those are elements that deter recruiters and employers from a CV. You know, if you're talking about demonstrating quality and one of your core strengths and key strengths is quality, and then I'm opening up a CV and I'm seeing mistakes and spelling mistakes and punctuation and formatting, I'm going to look at it and go, hey, oh, not so much. Okay. And then obviously gaps and incorrect dates. Okay. So I receive and view CVs on a daily basis, and I can't tell you if my expectation is not being managed, I'm seeing a lot of incorrect information coming through on CVs. Okay. Your brand matters. I'm just showing you what my brand looked like on LinkedIn at the moment. So if you do not have a LinkedIn profile at the moment, please get your LinkedIn profile open and running as quickly as possible. Start to look at how you start to optimize your brand. How do you brand you? LinkedIn is a platform to tell your audience what it is that you do. How do you differentiate yourself? You've got an opportunity to brand yourself. Of course, I'm a business, so I'm using this to brand my business and what I do, but I'm telling my target audience. So I'm not just Elise McCabe. I'm telling my target audience what it is that I actually do. So you have a phenomenal platform here to really market you and to stand out. So the program also helps you and offers advice in terms of how you can actually take your brand forward. And it's a very key headline that I've put to this. LinkedIn, your brand does actually matter. Okay. So just some quick methodology that you need to consider with LinkedIn. You know, we've moved into a market of networking. We've moved into a market of working collaboratively. You've got amazing connections. I mean, guys, you've got cell phones with connections. You've got a LinkedIn network that is phenomenal connections for you. You know, are you truly utilizing your networks? Are you truly utilizing the people that you actually know that will help you and possibly not? Okay. another element that we have been talking about, which is really important, is when we start to look and say and what they can't say, I am.
Sorry, we lost you for
have
a second.
Have you lost me?
Yeah.
Part of the retrenchment or job uncertainty is really looking at the financial aspects as well as knowing your rights. So, you know, in a retrenchment, at what point are you being retrenched? What is the age of retrenchment? It might be a case of if you are facing job uncertainty, getting ahead of it. You know, essentially don't wait until you're facing that. Start to get your financial affairs in order. Start to look at what it is that you need to get ready, what it is that you can actually do. So we will unpack and talk through, you know, some of these key elements that you need to be aware of. A lot of people don't realize, you know, what they can do from a debt consolidation, as an example, in terms of, you know, in terms of what my debt looks like at the moment. And I think this becomes a particularly key element if I'm facing retrenchment or job uncertainty and I'm wanting to start a business. I mean, my own example, I was facing retrenchment. I hadn't started my business before I was now sitting facing retrenchment. And I now go, well, how do I finance this? You know, do I dip in? Do I keep those going? You know, do I keep running those, you know, running with those? If I need to cut costs, where do I cut costs? How can I cut costs? So it's a very important component, whether I'm facing retrenchment or whether I'm concerned about my own job security in terms of starting to look at what my financial affairs look like. Okay. And back to knowing your rights. So many people sit and they feel it's a process that is obviously managed by the employer, but I actually don't know what I can and can't say. I don't know what my legal rights are. Am I being fairly treated in this particular process? Can I actually ask questions? If there's not good communication, what can I do and how do I go about mobilizing that communication? You know, what does that consultation process look like and what is involved with that? And again, I have so many conversations with people that they're out of it. They've been through the retrenchment process and the process is already concluded. And they go, oh gosh, I wish I had done that. Or I should have thought about that. Or I didn't know I could do that. And so we want to just empower with you with some of the knowledge and some of the advice so that you know what to expect and what you can and can't do. All right. So just talking through the program. The idea is
that Elise, I think we're losing your network a little bit every once in a while. Dombey?
Hello.
I'm just checking it's not me and that it's Elise.
We need to get you.
No, I can hear you.
Okay. I think we're losing. Yeah, it's okay, Dombey. I think we're losing your network just a little bit every once in a while, Elise. I think you're on mute now. I think Elise is on mute.
Sorry, I'm back. Yeah. Did I lose you?
You're back now. We lost you for a little bit, but now you're back.
Oh, okay, let me just go back here. Let's just get to where I was, just in terms of the program. Okay, all right, so I'm back. So the idea with the program is to really get
what I suggest, Elise, maybe switch off your
positive.
You can switch off your camera and then switch off your camera and then try it, because I think it's that 5:30, 6:00 and everybody's getting online. So your network is getting a little. So maybe if you want to switch off your camera.
Do that. Okay, guys. I must be honest. Guys, you. Yeah, sorry.
No problem.
You've lost me on perfect. Okay. Sorry, guys. Program is really looking at steps to recover from retrenchment. As I said, we need you to get you into a positive headspace. We need to get you into proactive.
Oh dear. Okay. Elise, do you want me to let, shall I give it a go in terms of finishing off? Because I think your network is looking. Oh, lost it completely. All right, so she'll come back just now. Yeah, I think it's peak time and she's having her challenges. So maybe what I can do in the meantime, as she comes back to start talking about the last bits of the program, what I'd like to do is, and I think she'll get into a little bit of detail around the program. What I'd like to do is just give an understanding as to more so as to what this program came about to do and why we think that it's important that not only is the program seen in a particular light, but the opportunity that we create. So career management and value add, for those of you who are not aware, is really geared up in terms of trying to do as much as possible to support and help in general cases, the youth. You're back, Elise, in the youth and as much as possible to support across the board some of the what I would call social aspects of the challenges that we're experiencing. And obviously retrenchment is one of them, but the program is designed in such a manner that when Elise goes through it in detail, there are other elements to it. So it's not one of those where you go through a program and then bye-bye, see you later, you're gone, and then you've got to figure it out for yourself. The idea here is the continuation of how to engage around different aspects of the experiences one is going to have, either through job uncertainty or retrenchment, even to the extent of being able to, to move into a new job and not sit back and go, okay, now that I'm in a new job, I'll be fine. Because as we know, 2021 is coming. It's going to be an extremely difficult year. And the prognosis of just the work and workplace environment is going to be slightly challenging. So what we have between career management and value add is a series of other programs. So what can happen is once one has completed the program within the space of job uncertainty and retrenchment, and that's the immediate meaningful experience you're going through, there's also a program on networking. And networking is essential on how you grow your base to be able to mitigate future circumstances and issues that may relate to either retrenchment or even business. How to grow your business, how to ensure that you're utilizing the right networks, but also how to utilize the right networks for your own personal benefit and growing. And what Elise also mentioned was this thing of personal branding and social media. So within ValueEd, we also have a personal branding and social media program that talks to how can you position yourself, brand yourself, and make sure that you become the lead focus for some of the social issues that you might meet. So whether it's a social issue related to your business, whether it's a social issue related to the workplace, whether it's a social issue related to just connection and engagements, how does personal branding and social media support that? And then the other one that we have is the Valuepreneur. It's a program designed for startup businesses. So I'm a startup business. How do people experience businesses? It's a very lonely place to be if you don't have somebody to talk to who can say, hey, this is what's going on in my world around finance. This is what's going on in my world around building teams. This is what's going on with my world around clients. So there's that element of it. And then finally, there's also a program called the Self-Mastery Program. We've got several others, but I thought these were important. And these are the ones that are, this program is geared to drive personal excellence and personal performance. So the reason why I'm giving these as examples is that retrenchment and job uncertainty is one component that people go through in life. And there are other components. And what we don't want as value add and career management is that we create something for you that means that after 3 months or 6 months, you're gone. If you need support and more help in addition to what you've been doing, these other programs also exist. Added to that, what we've done, and if Elise comes back, we'll show it to you, but otherwise I'll tell it to you, is we've said that these are all online programs on Zoom, right? So what that means is that, firstly, there are two things that we can do really nicely. Firstly, we can make it affordable. So this is not a program that's going to cost an arm and a leg. As a matter of fact, it is 350 rands a month. And for 350 rands a month, there are two sessions that are run for an hour and 15 minutes each in the course of that month, right? It's an ongoing program. And at any point you can say, look, I think I've got enough. I wanna jump off and I wanna do this other program, or I wanna stay on, because what we do is we're going to have a loop kind of system to the program. So we've tried to keep it as cheap and as palatable as possible. Obviously retrenchment and job uncertainty come with financial elements. So we need to try and ensure that that we try and keep that as reasonable as possible. The other thing that happens when you join the program is you become really part of a larger network. So what we also have, particularly within ValueAd, is a lot of events. For those of you who are not familiar with ValueAd, you know, we have, you know, events that are linked to women's events. We've got men of value events. We've got a whole series of other events. So it can grow the network of your capability. Hi, Elise, you back?
I'm back. Sorry about that, guys. My network has gone completely down. So I've moved to data. Sorry about that.
It happens. It's as long as you're not on rain and 5G. 5G is too soon. So what I've done was just quickly go through just what ValueAd is doing, the ability to link that, but please carry on and finish off the steps. No problem.
Thanks, guys. So what does COVID do for us? It really does teach us agility and patience and concern and care, right?
Absolutely.
Oh, thanks for the patience, guys. Okay. All right, so just to walk through this program, what I wanted to do was just basically, let's bring this up. I think, you know, Vic and I said, you know, we wanted to be provide a lot of flexibility around timelines. And the idea is that we know that a lot of people are impacted by retrenchment and job uncertainty right now. So the idea is to start this program, and I guess we'll have possibly different stages of starting this program on an ongoing basis as we get new groups of people joining. But the idea is to start this session as soon as possible. And so what I sort of indicated, and there is flexibility around this, but I thought, you know, to give us some planning and the individuals that want to join the session some time to plan and prepare, the idea would to be try and kick off the session, the first session starting on the 1st of December, and then to try and at least get the next one in before the holiday of the 16th of December. Now, it's a good time. December is a phenomenal time to plan. Yeah. I use it from a coaching perspective to work with my clients, particularly if you're in a stage of job uncertainty, or you finished your studies and now you need to get your plan together for 2021. You know, recruiters are recruiting, employers are looking for talent. So it doesn't mean that everything shuts down come the 16th of December. In fact, no, I think there's not going to be the traditional shutdown in most businesses. I think because of the time that's actually been lost, businesses need to make up, and obviously there's going to be ongoing talent scouting. But I know in my previous experience, prior COVID, and we're talking about 2019, Recruiters and employers were searching for talent the right through December. Maybe decisions, interviews, and so forth were only happening in the new year. But it's a really, really good time for planning, and that's why I earmarked that we would focus on the two elements indicated here as the kickoff sessions for December, that at least allows you to then take time to start implementing the plan. And then come early January, we can pick up and start looking at what does that CV look like? What does that networking plan look like? What does your LinkedIn profile look like? And are you utilizing it as effectively as you could? It's also really important to look at social media and the impact of social media. Employers are making decisions, hiring decisions based on your social media. I am naturally going to look you up and expect to see a LinkedIn profile when I am looking at your CV. So it's really, really important to have that. And then obviously job interview preparation. I think a lot of people underestimate the work that needs to go into interview preparation. Okay, phase two, really going into a lot more detail around the financial aspects, then looking at the law. It's important to know your rights. Guys, I'm not a labor specialist. I'm not a labor lawyer, but I'm very knowledgeable. And something that I will be looking at doing is incorporating industry specialists as guests. So when we look at the financial aspect, is to bring on somebody that I work closely with as a financial wellness expert, bring that person into the session. I work with a number of labor law specialists and possibly look at inviting a labor law specialist into the session as well. So from a question point of view, if there's going to be any tough or tricky questions, then at least we've got somebody that is an expert in that to basically address any questions there. And then, of course, you know, you have escaped round one of retrenchments, but you are still not sure. Gosh, could it be me? Could it be happening? You know, it's important to know what those warning signs actually are. And then very importantly, I think I try to maintain motivation, positivity throughout. It's important that we keep these sessions positive and dynamic. But, you know, it's important for us to also end off the program. With making sure that you've got the tools and you know where and how to stay motivated. It may be looking for a mentor. It may be, you know, there are various different people, but you need to identify those people that can keep you positive. You're going to have and you could have dark days. It's perfectly acceptable, but sitting on the couch and playing PlayStation or watching TV all day is not going to help you secure job opportunity or work. Okay, so when we look at what to expect from the program, let's get down to, and I'm sure everybody's got that burning question, so what is this program going to cost me and what is all involved with it? And so it is an advisory, it is interactive, it is via Zoom, it will be online. We're looking at running, I think Vic, based on Vic's success and the experience in terms of the sessions that Vic has run in his other services that he offers, I think two sessions a month is perfectly acceptable, and that's what we're looking at doing there. Now, as there will be interaction, it doesn't necessarily mean that there won't be engagement and there won't be correspondence and there won't be assistance around that. We need to obviously look at that, and we will decide what the actions are in each session. You will be given homework. There will be activities that you need to embark on. Otherwise, what's the point of involving yourself in this program? It's not about me doing the work. It is about you doing the work, and it's about you implementing your strategy and plan, and it's about you making the changes. Now, there's no point in giving me a CV to rewrite and edit. Where's the learning in that? Because, you know, every time you need to apply for a position, you need to edit and you need to customize your CV. So if I'm doing that work for you, where's the learning? How are you knowing or learning what you actually need to do? Okay. So in terms of pricing, guys, really affordable. I look at what the price points at the moment are in terms of one-on-one career coaching. And if I look at the outplacement programs, what the costs of those are, we're saying to you, you know, it's going to cost you 350 Rand a month for a period of 6 months. You know, so the investment is 2,100, but, you know, we've decided let's sweeten it for you. let's give you a little bit of a discount. You know, if we can get your commitment and you see that, you know, the 6 months is really going to be beneficial for you, then, you know, we'll give it to you at $1,750 and at least give you some discount. But obviously that is an upfront payment, and that's where the commitment comes in from that perspective. So guys, Vic and I believe we think it's a very good price. We've really tried to keep it as affordable as we possibly can. You know, we've really tried to keep the price down for you, so that it makes it something that, you know, particularly if you're facing retrenchment or job uncertainty, you know, not everybody has this big fat bank account that they can tap into. We understand that. So yeah, I mean, essentially that is, you know, the overview of the program that we want to embark on with you, and it's really a high level overview. So I want to just, you know, use this opportunity to open up to the floor and to everybody, if you've got any questions now for me, for Vic.
Yep, perfect one. I think
are there any questions in the chat at the moment? I haven't looked at those yet. Are there any questions that have come through on the chat?
No, not so much questions. I think just more comments. And predominantly from Mahlatsi. I think he's just mentioning that, you know, he knows the Valuepreneur course, so he's very much aware of that. And just talking about retrenchments in South Africa and expecting to see entrepreneurship rise. And I think he's right. So absolutely. I think from the context of anybody else, Melanie and also, if I'm not mistaken, Tato's on as well, if he's still on. If there are any questions, Dombi's one of the value-add folks who's joined us. If there are any questions from your side around this or anything that you want to know or anything you want some advice on. Melanie, Tato?
Guys, would love to hear. Hi, Melanie.
Hi. Okay, I don't have a question, but a comment. I think I resonated with a lot of the things that you said. I've just survived a retrenchment process. Oh. So I'm somewhere in between, is it time to move on? Is it time to just think around my next move? Not feeling very certain about the future. So yeah, a lot of the things that you said resonated with me. And yeah, I think I'm at that stage where I'm just trying to plan and relooking my career and just trying to think around next steps. Because yeah, the whole retrenchment process was stressful and draining and it was over a couple of months, and it actually wasn't done. That's my own opinion. It wasn't done in the most, I'd say, most effective. Considerate way, effective and considerate. So I think most of my colleagues were all over the place at the moment, emotionally, just trying to plan, even though we've survived. We don't know for how long we will stay in our role. So.
And look, thank you for that. If I may comment on that and just say that, you know, one, if one is in the position to take time off to reflect and just take some time back, because sometimes what happens, again, back to the analogy of relationships in any job situation, you know, the rebound, and if anybody's been in a relationship and had the experience of a rebound relationship, it's not necessarily sustainable, and it's often a rebound for the wrong reason. So sometimes we do embark and jump into the first thing that comes along for the wrong reasons. Sometimes we don't have a choice. That's the card that's dealt, right? Or the hand that's dealt. But I think if you are in the position where you can really take a step back and start looking at that, that's really important. And sounds like Melanie, you're in that space. But this is where the planning is so important. You know, we spend so much time in our business, in our studies, focusing on that. And that's important. I mean, at the end of the day, that's in a job, that's what we get paid for, and we've got accountability and responsibility. But, you know, we often forget about what our plan is and what that future should look like, and especially in the retrenchment space. So you know, that plan, you've got to start to look and say, well, what are my strengths? What is my value proposition? You get so caught up in the mundane day-to-day stuff, but what is your value? I mean, when I start to unpack and look at CVs with individuals, I look at so many CVs, and to be honest today, I've looked at 4 CVs today through consulting, and there was not one person that had indicated their achievements on their CV. And I'm going, well, how do I differentiate you? How are you differentiating yourself? Because that's not coming through in terms of your CV. But in the planning, in terms of if it's not clear yet, you know, it's fine to go on this, you know, that's where the discovery becomes so important in terms of, you know, sometimes it's not just about looking at the job title. It's about looking at the industry. So, you know, maybe it's been the heart. Part of what I've done is always focused on the function and not the heart. But maybe, you know, it's I want to focus in an organization that is really about the heart. I can still do what I do, but I like the values or the heart of what that organization does. So you've got to think of yourself as a project now, in many respects. You know, we go to market. So if I look at Vic and I, we came up with this idea, we were brainstorming it, we've been thinking about it, how do we go to market? So there's so many facets to, you know, to work and projects and marketing and initiatives and so forth that we've got to, who do we communicate? Who's our target audience? And how do we take this to market? And that's what's important for you now. How do you take you to market, and what is the plan behind that? So, you know, what is that LinkedIn profile going to say about you, and how do you want that to engage and position you from a brand perspective with your target audience? And that's why I say this job campaign plan doesn't mean it's about necessarily securing a job in a corporate again. It's the planning or the action activity and the discovery around that might lead you to starting a business. The discovery that you might go through is saying, well, I'm not sure. Maybe it's a business, and maybe it's going back into corporate. It doesn't mean that you have to ignore, you know, focus on one and not the other. You can focus on both in tandem and see what results come out of that. But the planning and investing time in you is so important, and that's the biggest thing we often neglect.
I second that. And Melanie, I guess I jumped before the retrenchment. But I knew it was coming in the company that I was in, and I was a senior executive there. And one of the decisions I made was to leave. And fortunately, I was able to give myself a bit of time. And I think to Elisa's point, I kind of saw the movie coming. So I was able to put the necessary things into place to leave in a manner in which, not that it was made any easier, because again, it's always what you were saying, Elise, it's not your choice. But one of the biggest things that I found having left was the need to really start determining my why and who I am. So one of the things I did, and you talk about this about social media, is I Googled myself. And everything I found about me wasn't about me, it was about companies. So it gave my entire CV in terms of working in the organizations I worked for. But none of it talked about who I was. So, and what I've done literally in the last 4 or 5 months is completely changed that deliberately and consciously, because I wanted to understand my why, and I wanted to link my why back to whatever it is that I was going to be doing, whether it was from a business perspective or a work perspective. And the reason why that's important is because when I stand on the mountaintop and look out across the horizon, the challenge of workplace is going to continue, and it's going to probably get over time a little bit worse. So what happens is that where traditionally we just looked for a job, found it, and milled our way through life, there is going to have to be a little bit more succinctness in terms of what we're choosing to do. Because what we're choosing to do, as exactly what Lilise said, is going to be reflected in how you put down your CV, right? And what it says about you. And it's going to be reflected in how you're interviewed. And because it's not like the good old days, I'm from Generation Z, where maybe 10, maybe 15 CVs went in for a job, right? Now it's 1,000 CVs going in for a job, to your point. Which means the competition is extremely harder, which means the decision making is extremely harder, which means the process is extremely longer. So there is a need for, in my personal view, for people to have hybrids of what it is that they do, but more importantly, centered in that is that personal brand of yours that defines your why, because I think that's what's going to be the differentiator in terms of, you know, Melanie may be a cook and Vic may be a cook, but Melanie specializes in spaghetti and Vic specializes in Chinese food. So we need to be, rather than just us being cooks, which is, I think, currently the way CVs are reflecting themselves now.
Absolutely. And Vic, to the point, and the same with LinkedIn as well, you know, in terms of positioning that brand. But, you know, you talk about being deliberate. And that is, you know, just applying for a job, as I alluded to earlier, is not enough. You've got to start to think differently around where do you find the job and where do I want to work? And this is where the art of networking comes in and the art of, you know, really sort of saying to your target audience, hello, hi, this is me. I'm here. This is how I can help you. This is how I can add value to you. This is a differentiation I can make to you. And you know, you've got to have quite a sort of a diverse strategy, and you've got to start looking at it as a strategy. It's a lot more scientific, I think, than what it traditionally used to be in terms of applying for a job. Particularly to your point, you know, you're one of 1,000 CVs, and I spoke about the ghosting. You know, I encounter that in conversations every single day. People go, gosh, Elise, I've applied for so many jobs and I'm just not getting callbacks. And then remember, in the space of uncertainty or facing retrenchment, you know, if you're highly emotional or you emotionally experiencing difficulties at the moment and you're applying and you know, getting no feedback as bad as rejection.
No, it is.
We don't want that to happen. We don't want you to keep being ghosted or just, you know, getting zero progression forward. And so this is where it's not enough just to apply for a job and then sit back and wait. Because you may never get that call back. And there's a high probability one, because your CV actually hasn't even been looked at. So what do you do? You know, and this is where, you know, this, you know, proactive strategy and being intentional and looking at this plan around your approach to transitioning into the market becomes so important. And what does that network look like? Who is your network?
It also alleviates the anxiety and the
absolutely and we've got to, absolutely. I mean, you know, if I can put it this way, anybody that is looking to transition will have some degree of anxiety. I'm not happy in my job for whatever reason. I want to move. But if I've got security and there's no, I'm not fearing possibly retrenchments, I feel quite comfortable where I am. Yes, there might not be as much urgency to transitioning, but I'm okay. So the levels of anxiety may be not as high as somebody that has already been impacted by retrenchment or doesn't have a job.
Yep.
But it doesn't mean that it's still not an emotional roller coaster. It doesn't mean that they're still not, because you start to question your self-worth and you start to think, well, sure, I'm not good. I'm not this. I'm not. And so you start thinking negatively about self. And sometimes it's not that at all. You've done nothing wrong in the process. And that's where, you know, back to you, if you don't know what you don't know and nobody's telling you what you don't know, you still don't know. And so feedback becomes so important. And if it's not forthcoming for you, this is the uncomfortable space sometimes you need to move into, because what are you going to do to get that feedback? And these are some of the skills and tools and discussions that we need to have that you feel comfortable about, you know, taking that step, because maybe you've never had to, or maybe you're a bit nervous and you're not sure how to do that.
No, absolutely. Tato, I see you're on. Do you want to say anything? Tato,
no,
maybe not. Okay. All right. So I think, you know, maybe not to take up everybody too much time from everybody. So I think Melanie, I think, and Tato, and yeah, thanks, Ntombi, and Mahlatsi, you've seen the dates and times. Please let us know. We will be putting up another time and opportunity to go through the overview before that first session that kicks off. But I do highly recommend coming onto the program. And again, I say not just for the basis of only the program, but for also the basis of what as you know, as value add and career management, we're able to do to support you from a one-on-one individual point of view in terms of some of the other programs that are there and some of the other networking capabilities that are there. Look, you don't have to be, you're not excluded from the networking capabilities if you're not on the program. Some of these events we are continuing to run, but they are certainly supportive in the process of expanding networks, meeting new people, and getting to that sense of understanding that there's a wider network of people who are doing different things that might end up being beneficial to yourself. So please feel free to do that, to join us and let us know. And hopefully the price isn't too inhibiting. If it is, if there's any chance that you may know people who are wanting to come onto the program, but you know the process has happened in such a way that they are financially affected, please let us know as well. We have sort of mechanisms in which we can look at and work out how we can support. We really want this to be you experiencing the program and not having any inhibiting factors, because we know it's a very difficult and stressful position and situation to find oneself in a certain, either retrenched or in a period of job uncertainty. So one of the things I will say, Melanie and Tato and Prince, I know you join these programs, but particularly for the two of you, something just to think about as a takeaway is that we started advertising this probably about two or three, maybe about 2 weeks ago, maybe about, you know, maybe slightly less than 2 weeks ago. And for me, you're the first that are on, right? So that says something. You've got one step, you've taken one step further than, you know, most people that you've probably been retrenched with, et cetera, et cetera. And I think that's a powerful thing. So I always say that in most things that I want to do in life, that I always assess myself against where everybody is. And if I've managed to take that step a little bit quicker, I try to utilize that momentum for my own personal psychology. But that's just something to think about.
Vic, just a question. I haven't included this, and it just dawned on me now. But if anybody on the group is interested in signing up, to join, where should they go?
Well done. Yes, absolutely. And it's one of those, you know, critical selling tools, but one forgets. So if you go to, and we'll put it up. Please just follow us in terms of wherever you've seen this. We'll put it up again in the constructs of just communication. But where you went into to register for this, you went into ValueEd website. If you go back into that website, the ValueEd website, and you scroll down on the homepage, you will come to our programs. And on our programs, you will see the job uncertainty element of it, the job uncertainty, to say view here, click there, a pop-up will come up just with the content and information in terms of where you can make payments. Going to ask you to please use your email address as a reference number. We'll come back to you once we actually have receipt of that. And then from there, from the 1st of December, what we normally do is we put you into a WhatsApp group. For now, because of the size numbers, it won't be too complicated, where we feed you with the dates and information and times of all the and the links of all the sessions that you're going to be part of. So you don't forget. All you do is click on the link and then you're into the session. And that's how we'll, that's how that process would run once the payment is made. So yeah, so that's go into exactly where you went into to register. Go into the home page of that events page where you registered. Scroll down, look for value add programs. You will see the program retrenchment and job uncertainty. Click on that. There'll be a pop-up with the actual banking details, etc., in terms of where you can do the EFT. It'll stipulate there, please use your email address. Ntombi here is the one who will get in touch with you to say we've received your payment. We'll then put you in the WhatsApp group for updates on and the links on the sessions on Tuesday, the 1st of December, and Monday, the 14th of December, as they stay on the, on those dates and times. Great.
Good, super. Thanks. Thanks.
Fantastic. Oh. All okay, Melanie?
Yes, all okay. Thank you so much for that.
Fantastic. I hope you got all that, Tato. And thanks for joining, Mahlatsi. Thanks for joining. And yeah, let's. Hopefully, we'll see you on the Tuesday, the 1st of December.
Fantastic. Lovely, guys. Thanks. Thanks so much for joining us. Lovely to have you on the session. And hopefully, we'll see you soon.
Have a good evening.